breaking riots about to erupt. Washington is bracing for a white civil rights rally on Sunday organized to coincide with the anniversary of last year's racially charged violence in Charlottesville, Virginia, Reuters reports. The Unite the Right to event is scheduled to take place at 5:30 p.m., 2130 GMT, in Lafayette Square, across the street from the White House. Several counter-protests have also received permission to gather nearby. Authorities have promised an enormous police presence to keep both sides apart and avoid the street brawls that broke out last year in downtown Charlottesville. A local woman, Heather Hare, was killed when an Ohio man, James Fields, drove his car into a crowd of counter-protesters. Sunday's demonstrations and the opposing rallies are taking place in an atmosphere of heightened racial tension. In recent months, anxiety over racial bias and racism has been exemplified in instances in which police were called on people of color for innocuous acts like napping in a dormitory common room, having a barbecue, and going to the pool. This week, NFL players in the first preseason games resumed their protest over police brutality against blacks by raising their fists, kneeling or sitting out during the national anthem. The funny thing is, during the off-season, we never saw a player taking up social justice and protesting, we never saw the NFL or any of their players speaking out against Chicago shootings or police officers being ambushed. So do not fall for their propaganda and lies. This is not acceptable and they are destroying the NFL, and it is time for America to walk away and leave the NFL behind. NFL players continued to protest during the national anthem on Thursday night as the league began the first full week of its 2018 preseason. RWT News article on NFL lies and fake protests. Organizers of #Occupy Lafayette Park, a civil rights group that holds nightly protests in the square, held up posters reading Love America, Hate Trump and Defend the District from White Supremacy just a few steps away from the White House. Metropolitan Police Chief Peter Newsom said officers will endeavor to keep far-right demonstrators and counter-protesters separate from one another. Guns will be forbidden near the rally site, regardless of whether an individual has a permit to carry the firearm. Our role is to make sure we have a First Amendment event that goes on without any types of violence or destruction of property, Newsom said at a Monday news conference, according to OP. We intend to have the entire police department engaged to make sure that we handle this type of thing. As the nation's capital, we host millions of visitors each year, said D.C. Mayor Muriel Bowser, a Democrat, in a statement. Fortunately, very few share the views that will be expressed in Lafayette Park on Sunday. Washington, D.C., is a city of love, inclusion and diversity, she continued, and, like millions of Americans across the nation, we know that the people who are coming here to profess hate and sow division are wrong. Saturday, some crowds showed up in the city, which was under a state of emergency.